Example of electronic harassment, which is demonic harassment. Again, here you have incorrect. They've been following the channel for some years, and I've seen that something was bubbling just below the surface. It was a demon spirit of pride, racism, prejudice, you know, all of those, that legion. And it definitely had them bound, and we've talked a couple of times, and they've even apologized for being out of themselves. They need prayer. Now, what I found interesting was that there's no space for me to, aside from once they were called a demon, they didn't say, I'm not a demon. Somebody said, get out of here, you demon, and they said, make me. So that was a manifestation. Now, what's interesting is that whoever comments, there's a reply button on my side. There's no reply button here. There's no reply button for incorrect. Or for any of the comments from incorrect. So I couldn't even jump in there and tell the people, hey, don't feed the animals. But it's very obvious, you know, what this was all about. In case you can't read it and you want me to. I've been following your channel for years, and it's hilarious how you say all these things that are true and good and acceptable. But then you, in your niggerish nature, start blabbering total Detroit ghetto style nigger BS. Get your head out of your A. Your arrogance and pride are astonishing at times. Mostly when you're angry at the powers that be. Typical nigger behavior when you address the government / establishment authority as if they're the only people, not as if they don't do, but as if they're the only people, so that's an admission that they do it, that do abominable, disgusting things when the blacks in America, as we say, when you people, are by far the most hateful and criminal group that ever came to existence. What a blanket accusation. Unfair and full of vitriol. Claiming that Jesus was black without any evidence but vain philosophy. Again, having nothing to do with the video or with anything that I talk about on this channel on the regular. Okay, perhaps they're upset that I use a depiction of Jesus that represents myself in my community, in my family. He's family to me. But okay, again, if I use the white picture, would they feel better? What's the big deal? And then a lot of people don't even have a problem with that who are not people of color nowadays. Anyway, claiming that Jesus was black without any evidence but vain philosophy. Again, this is not something that I spend my time teaching. I'm the one who keeps saying, who is my mother and who is my brother but those are the will of my father. I'm the one that keeps saying that. I'm the one that keeps saying, hey, don't get lost into the legalism of things and get caught up in a sense of intellectual superiority because you call it this and call it that. when you're not even doing the works out of the names that you claim. So I'm the one that does that. But yet this is the attack. So that goes to show you that, again, this is not somebody operating from their right mind. So when you run up against a lunatic, if you argue with a fool, a passerby may look and wonder which one of y'all is the fool. So we're not going to argue. And again, you know, I overstand when folks have had enough. Okay. And when somebody's being arrogant and disrespectful, you know, it brings something out of us. But we have to fight from another place. We don't fight fire with fire. It's okay. So, yeah, but, you know, they go off into that whole thing. And, of course, we was Jesus, way to go, okay? Never, ever came out of my mouth. So, I mean, the caricature that they have of me is so far from the reality that this is a person that is, they're in denial, because when they're called to the carpet on it, why not say, well, yeah, I'm serious. This is what I mean. So, what this is, sarcasm, their attempted sarcasm. Again, you see the logo here, their icon is of a dissatisfied cat. Now, this is a white female, or at least they've proposed themselves to be, on some older videos, and I could find it if I cared to. You know, they actually told a little bit about themselves and said that they were struggling with racial issues. Okay? So now this is what mind control is supposed to do. And yes, it's a psyop, but this person is an example. If you ask my opinion, this is an example of the Black Awakening coming into full effect. In a lot of ways, it is going to come into full effect. What's the Black Awakening? Let's find another name for it, can we? Well, let's describe it first, and then the Father will give us the name. It is the phenomenon of all of the agent smithable people who are not sealed vessels, sealed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. They don't have the Holy Spirit operating and leading their choices and thoughts in life. They're not in a oneness with the mind of the Lord Jesus Christ. They can be accessed now, and they are being accessed and activated on a huge scale, as if a blanket wave of demonic presence has been released. And that blanket wave finds its mark in the unsealed individual, who can then be used as the host for demon spirits that can match the vibration that they've already been trained in. Whatever issue was in their tissue that had not been resolved. Now we are at this point now where this can manifest into something like this. But let's look at some more examples, because, you know, again, I think that, you know, because I try to be a bottom line person. I dealt with the bottom line of how to conquer, how I conquered, let me say, being harassed and targeted. Am I not a targeted individual? Don't I do enough to get targeted? My brothers and sisters, so I came to you from the perspective of the victor, because I've received the victory in Christ. So now we want to look some more at some things that happen to victims, okay? Because I think folks need to feel as if they're being sympathized and empathized with, first and foremost, before they can even move into a place where they're no longer in a victim or victimized state of thought or being, and then they can move into that place of victory that's for everyone, because God is no respecter of persons. He does not favor me more than he favors you. So that was my intention in the first video, but in this video, that is indeed what I'm going to do. All praise is due to the loving and true. In a minute. Mercy on you. Here's an example of electronic harassment, which is demonic harassment. Again, here you have Incorrect. They've been following the channel for some years, and I've seen that something was bubbling just below the surface. It was a demon spirit of pride, racism, prejudice, you know, all of those, that legion. And it definitely had them bound, and we've talked a couple of times, and they've even apologized for being out of themselves. I don't know if they're on medication or what. They need prayer. Now, what I found interesting was that there's no space for me to, aside from once they were called a demon, they didn't say, I'm not a demon. Somebody said, get out of here, you demon. And they said, make me. So that was a manifestation. Now, what's interesting is that whoever comments, there's a reply button on my side. There's no reply button here. There's no reply button for incorrect. Or for any of the comments from incorrect. So I couldn't even jump in there and tell the people, hey, don't feed the animals. But it's very obvious, you know, what this was all about. In case you can't read it and you want me to. I've been following your channel for years, and it's hilarious how you say all these things that are true and good and acceptable. But then you, in your niggerish nature, start blabbering total Detroit ghetto style nigger BS. Get your head out of your A. Your arrogance and pride are astonishing at times, mostly when you're angry at the powers that be. Typical nigger behavior when you address the government / establishment authority as if they're the only people, not as if they don't do, but as if they're the only people, so that's an admission that they do it, that do abominable, disgusting things when the blacks in America, as we said, when you people, are by far the most hateful and criminal group that ever came to existence. What a blanket accusation. Unfair and full of vitriol. Claiming that Jesus was black without any evidence but vain philosophy. Again, having nothing to do with the video or with anything that I talk about on this channel on the regular. Okay, perhaps they're upset that I use a depiction of Jesus that represents myself and my community and my family. He's family to me. But okay. I mean, if I use the white picture, would they feel better? What's the big deal? And then a lot of people don't even have a problem with that who are not people of color nowadays. Anyway, claiming that Jesus was black without any evidence but vain philosophy. Again, this is not something that I spend my time teaching. I'm the one who keeps saying, who is my mother and who is my brother but those who do the will of my father. I'm the one that keeps saying that. I'm the one that keeps saying, hey, don't get lost into the legalism of things and get caught up in a sense of intellectual superiority because you call it this and call it that when you're not even doing the works out of the names that you claim. So I'm the one that does that. But yeah, this is the attack. So that goes to show you that, again, this is not somebody operating from their right mind. So when you run up against a lunatic, if you argue with a fool, a passerby may look and wonder which one of y'all is the fool. So we're not going to argue. And again, you know, I overstand when folks have had enough. Okay. And when somebody's being arrogant and disrespectful, you know, it brings something out of us. But we have to fight from another place. We don't fight fire with fire. It's okay. So, yeah, but, you know, they go off into that whole thing. And of course, we was Jesus, way to go, okay? Never, ever came out of my mouth. So, I mean, the caricature that they have of me is so far from the reality that this is a person that is, they're in denial, because when they're called to the carpet on it, why not say, well, yeah, I'm serious. This is what I mean. So, what this is, sarcasm, their attempted sarcasm. Again, you see the logo here, their icon, is of a dissatisfied cat. Now this is a white female, or at least they've proposed themselves to be, on some older videos, and I could find it if I cared to. You know, they actually told a little bit about themselves and said that they were struggling with racial issues. Okay, so now this is what mind control is supposed to do, and yes, it's a psyop, but this person is an example. If you ask my opinion, this is an example of the black awakening coming into full effect. In a lot of ways, it is going to come into full effect. What's the black awakening? Let's find another name for it, can we? Well, let's describe it first, and then the Father will give us the name. It is the phenomenon of all of the agent smithable people. People who are not sealed vessels, sealed by the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. They don't have the Holy Spirit operating and leading their choices and thoughts in life. They're not in a oneness with the mind of the Lord Jesus Christ. They can be accessed now, and they are being accessed and activated on a huge scale, as if a blanket wave of demonic presence has been released. And that blanket wave finds its mark in the unsealed individual, who can then be used as the host for demon spirits that can match the vibration that they've already been trained in. Whatever issue was in their tissue that had not been resolved. Now we are at this point now where this can manifest into something like this. But let's look at some more examples, because, you know, again, I think that, you know, because I try to be a bottom line person. I dealt with the bottom line of how to conquer, how I conquer, let me say, being harassed and targeted. Am I not a targeted individual? Don't I do enough to get targeted, my brothers and sisters? So I came to you from the perspective of the victor, because I've received the victory in Christ. So now we want to look some more at some things that happen to victims, okay? Because I think folks need to feel as if they're being sympathized and empathized with, first and foremost, before they can even move into a place where they're no longer in a victim or victimized state of thought or being, and then they can move into that place of victory that's for everyone, because God is no respecter of persons. He does not favor me more than he favors you. So that was my intention in the first video, but in this video, that is indeed what I'm going to do. All praise is due to the loving and true. In a minute. Have mercy on you.
Peace, blessings, love, wisdom, and understanding be with you all from the true and loving Father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who came in the flesh, manifest as the Messiah, Jesus of Nazareth, the name above every name that is also outside of the realm of logic, academic, and scholarly understanding. For it is not by might, not even the might of intellect, that you can get to know the Most High Creator. Regardless of what sometimes we are fooled into believing by the clever machinations of the Most Low. And do not feed the animals, please, please. When y'all see them demons show up and show out, don't give them what they want, okay? Don't drop a Scooby snack in their mouth. Now one, that feeds them. Now, for those who are new here, some folks, I think, on the last video only clicked in because they saw something of interest in the title, and I know that happens, but it's more important that I take a little time here to just be sure that I'm clear that I have been at one time a person who has experienced some fear after realizing the level of targeting that was going on. And, you know, folks who experience this generally, and I mean, you know, I've had a lot of stories come to me, some of them new, and then some of them are stories in the past that I'm going to revisit or draw from in this broadcast, stories that at that time we did not define as gang stalking. The term was not in vogue or well known, let's say that. It's okay to, you know, be sure and not sound in any way as if I'm minimalizing or glossing over a very serious subject, okay? So what I want to do is not just show empathy and sympathy. I want to empathize and sympathize, but I want to also show and prove that we realize what folks have in common. Generally, what folks will say is that, you know, and this is most folks, hey, they were looking up certain things. They tripped the tripwires. Again, I've talked about these things. I've done videos on this before it was known as this. So that's why a lot of the older viewers didn't have a problem with it. I think some of the newer ones who have been, unfortunately, taken advantage of by folks who like to get a lot of hits and views, and also by some folks who don't realize how they're being used to help to spread a sense of fear and dread and victimization that keeps a person from the realization that you can overcome. At the end of the day, that, you know, that's going to be the end of this message. So if you want to listen to a message that will further feed into the fact that you've been defeated for some reason, I mean, you know, it almost seems as if that's what some folks, you know, the part of the programming is to break down and tear down your will to fight, and then to break down and tear down your belief and your faith that anything can save you. But if that's what you're looking for, then you're at the wrong video. Now, what I will explain to you is how I overcame. And I mean, you know, you may say, well, I'm lightweight jamming over here. I'm a baby bear square. Who am I? I'm just a brother from Detroit. I ain't nowhere. I have some enemies. I have some enemies. Okay. My enemies have supernatural abilities. They also have access to silent weapons that they use for quiet wars. My enemies use psychological operations. They also use witchcraft and sorcery, which does still exist, and some folks don't even recognize that. I recognize this. They also can use impulse weapons or pulse weapons, weapons using electromagnetic frequencies. They also can attack my computer. It's happened a number of times. They attack my videos. They also like to let it be known on the low-low that they're doing it. Oh, come on, all right? I know there are companies and whatnot. It's lightweight jamming. You could hire a company to harass somebody, you know, a fellow frat brother, or somebody who's in opposition to your company. You can hire people who will do this. I think that most folks who are going through a serious thing with this are talking about the higher people who can do this, okay? H-I-G-H-E-R. Higher levels, higher devils. So then if we can all agree that, okay, once you look up certain things, sure, your name goes into a database. Sure, once you put out certain things, okay, but most folks experience it or experience some level of it, some level of harassment, some level of the powers that be and the spirits that empower them, letting it be known, hey, we see you. Like in They Live, okay? One of my favorite films of all time. Lots of analogies. Oh my goodness, the black and white analogy. So many things that we can draw from if we watch They Live. Even how the climactic scene of the movie takes place at a news station. Mm-hmm. And some of the first people that we were able to see through using the lenses that they place over the modern day TVs, really using the lenses that the Father gave us to be able to see. Messiah said, those who have eyes to see and ears to hear. But we were able to first see a lot of broadcasters, reporters, you know, maybe we'll talk a little bit about why that's so. I mean, just in general, but you know, I want to get down to the meat of things. I mean, some things, you know, I believe would be so heinous that it would be hard to get a human to do it right, or to do it convincingly. Some things have to be brought forth by the children of the father of lies. In this wicked and adulterous generation, there are those who are really born of vipers, as Messiah said. But let's keep it straight. Let's keep the straight line going. So we can agree that, hey, once you look up certain things, once you go certain places, yeah, in some cases, but generally, because of this technology that has been so lovingly given to us by the fallen angels, who first brought it down to mankind on Mount Hermon to cause man harm, for harming man, along with technology that gave man medicine. They taught man the use of herbs and weaponry and technology, cosmetics as well. We don't call the Book of Enoch canon per se, but we know that there's enough reference to Enoch in the canon, in scripture, and even through Messiah, okay, to say, okay, well, it's not canon, but perhaps we can learn from it. Do we not learn from things that are outside of canon every day by the Father's choosing? And some of those things don't have a lick of biblical cut to it, okay? Not a sprinkle of anything biblical can be found in it, at least not on the surface. And yet we can still find some truth in some of those things some of the time. So then how much more could we perhaps find some truth in something that is at least arguably connected to scripture? At least people argue and debate that. We can learn things from the Matrix. I mean, you know, okay. Which, although you may find things that you say, well, yeah, that's based on scripture too, Brother Theo. You just like to argue, some of you. You know what I mean. I mean, that is light years, okay? Learning something from that isn't even in the same building as learning something from one of the quote-unquote lost books or one of the books of the Apocrypha, which again are argued by some Holy Spirit guided men as having a lot of truth within. So that's why we spend some time talking about the fallen angels and the adversary on this channel. We talk a little bit about his weapons to help to bring it back home, because I think sometimes we look at electronics and technology with a little bit of reverence as fear. Stay here. Father sent you here. Stay here. Reverence as fear. Why is it that the Father requires fear? The true and living, the true and loving, Most High, Creator, requires fear. It's one of the seven spirits as told by the prophet Isaiah in the Ancient of Days in the Book of Revelation. The spirit of knowledge, the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of understanding, the spirit of counsel, the spirit of God's might, the spirit of the Lord, and the spirit of the fear of the Lord. Why is that? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of all wisdom, we learn in Proverbs. But then, God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Perfect love cast out all fear. So if God is perfect love, how can it be fear? See, there goes that demon spirit of, y'all gonna be on the lookout for Cerebro. Watch out for Cerebro, people. Yes, Pastor Bill Ricks and Brother Charles had to touch and agree to get Cerebro up off of me. Mercy. When you've learned a lot, and perhaps you've gotten good at brainstorming. Interesting term. Peace be still. Let the Holy Spirit lead, so then you can truly learn and discern. So, fear is required by the Father as a form of reverence. And it's the closest thing that, you know, F-E-A-R is false evidence appearing real. But fear is, you know, that's the closest thing that I suppose the translators could come up with. It would be interesting. And I mean, you can do so in your spare time if it will edify you, if you need it. It would be interesting to look at what word is really there in the original texts, if we can trust that we can actually access those. But let's let the Holy Spirit be our guide. And by Jeremiah 33:3 and Proverbs 3:5, the Holy Spirit will lead us, okay? Because the word is living, it's alive. So all we have to do, again, is just get into the Holy Spirit, the same Holy Spirit that inspired it, and we'll overstand. The fear that the Father requires of you is like the fear that really your earthly Father should have put in you in a righteous manner. Yes, Lord. Mm-hmm. Some of y'all did not receive the rod like you should have. You were spoiled. And then some of you didn't believe the rod like you should have. You just showed enough hard hit it. Hit hard as a hickory nut. Rebellious, raw, and uncut. But the fear of the Father in heaven does indeed refine you. But more importantly, it's also supposed to be there to remind you that because of your reverence for the Father in heaven, there's no need or reason to fear anything on earth. Anything on earth. Even the fallen angels who were cast down, and the things to which they have men bound, the things that they brought down here with them, including technology. Now, this took me some time, so let me please not sound as if I'm coming from some sort of arrogant frame of mind, because I'm telling you that the same peace that I found is the peace that you can find, because our Father's no respect of persons. He don't love me more than he love you. So if anything, the confidence that you hear is the confidence in the only one that I fear. Get some. You can get some too. It's down here. He poured out his spirit in these last days, according to Joel. Get it. Get a feel of it. Won't be so scared. Some people are comfortable in fear and in a place of victimization. And some people are comfortable in a place of pity. Some people are not. Some people are. We're going to deal with all of them before this is over. Mm-hmm. And then some people are just in a state of confusion. They don't know what to do. We're going to deal with all three of y'all before we through. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm just jotting that down just to make sure. Word is bond and word is true. Ain't talking about no Mason. I'm tired of how they took some of the most deep concepts in the supernatural reality of the Holy Spirit given to us by the Father through the Son, and then turned them into New Age, the Aquarian Age. And therein, they're doing works. How can you get to the greater works if you're too afraid to be able to manifest the works? Afraid of what men might say. Afraid of how the family might turn against you. Afraid of the comfort zone that you're in no longer being there for you, in case you got to run back there again. Because you know once you start off on this walk, it's no going back. Afraid that somehow once you start working for the Father, you're going to experience a sense of lack. Oh, you fear everything down here below except for the Father. If you truly feared the Father the way that you should, that is fear as reverence. We talked about this in the last video. If you're not up on it, get up on it, okay? So we can keep going forward. We don't want to keep rehashing. But I think this part needs to be driven home. If you had that fear of the father as fear of reverence, like you should have learned in the home. But again, we know that the powers that be, the adversary, have attacked the family structure, especially the nuclear family. And that was it, you know, that was a pointed and effective attack. Whatever it is, it sounds awful. Very well directed by the general of the opposing army. So that, you know, folks have a lack of faith in their physical father, and that does indeed reflect onto how you have faith or have a problem having faith or have a lack of faith in the Heavenly Father. Dumb down some stuff. So now, again, let me show a little bit most, you know, I understand, because I think that some folks got the sense that, I thought that only demons are swooping down with bat wings and, you know, tickling your toes in the middle of the night. No, I know people who are suffering from the lowest and vilest forms of evil. I know someone who works in a very demonic environment. It's a casino. And while they're there, there's something going on through the air that bothers them. More specifically, that manipulates their private parts and other areas of their body. Now, they don't know if they've been chipped or what has occurred with that. There are chipped individuals that we work with on this channel. And prayer blocks the things of the prince of the power of the air. But the reason that the devil wants to keep everybody in such a scare concerning technology and all the weapons he has out there is so that you don't believe you can pray and get any relief from them. No how, no way. That's what the devil wants you to believe. And that ain't what I came here to say. So again, if that's what you want to hear, please leave. No offense to you. I ain't capping on you. I ain't gonna have you capping on me either. Every tongue that rises up against me shall be condemned, and some of them is gonna be X'd out of this comment section. Please believe. You know, who cares? Okay, you shouldn't care, because I don't. I couldn't care less. I wish I could. But folks come in there up to no good talking that mess. Don't feed the animals. Not in here. We got enough enemies. Let's deal with the ones who are really tough enemies, not them lightweight jamming Smurfs, gremlins. Kick them off your shoe. And keep stomping through your turf like you're supposed to. Let's continue. Yeah, when the Holy Spirit, the Father's creative. That's all I got to tell you. He's creative. Don't be jealous. Don't be angry. Mm-hmm. I come to you out of humility. I come to you to share some of my story and some of the stories of others. Some folks are my sisters, some are my brothers, and some are my love. I know another individual who don't bother nobody, don't go nowhere, don't do nothing to bother nobody. But yet, and I mean pray all day, sing songs to the Father, listen to the Word, you know, tries to find ministering videos on YouTube to listen to all day long. But in the quietness of their home, sometimes in their mind, they hear the devil say, kill yourself. Or some sort of psychotronic weapon shooting that frequency through their mind. Kill yourself. And guess what happened one day? When nobody was around, nobody could be found to try to help to talk to them or calm them down, they took a butcher knife to their wrist and slit it. The neighbors heard the hollering and called the police. The police got there in time to get them to the hospital, break down the door, get them to the hospital, and that was only by the will and the strength and the power of the Lord. Because, you know, this is DPD we talking about. They not likely to do that extra effort and break into a house because somebody may be killing themselves when there's so many situations going on in the city of Detroit. So the Father sent the right ones. Now, again, these are just some examples that I know what can be done. Now, coincidentally, both individuals that I'm speaking of, and I'm going to speak on some more, all of the individuals I'm going to speak on have connections to the secret societies through their families. The families, you know, whether they know it or not, have been used as the agents of the prince of the power of the air. The families oftentimes, you know, unknowingly help to carry out these attacks of harassment. Sometimes knowingly. There has to usually there has to be someone who knows. That's my opinion in every case. In every case. And there's only one case where the individual, and I mean, they was close to their family, where the, I wrote down about seven that I could think of offhand, okay? But in this one case, and I didn't write them all down, I'm sure I missed some, but in one case, they are aware, okay, wow, my family's not like I thought it was. Wow, this relative of mine who's been involved with the Brotherhood for a long time, deeply involved, okay, we're not talking about lightweight jammers, but now we even have to start looking at lightweight jammers, ladies and gentlemen, because they are now being used as houses or vessels, beths, if you will, hosts to which demonic energy can be infused, and that demonic energy has been sent out broadcast. This has been going on. Okay. It's one of the reasons why you have so many of them towers around your way. Those towers is not just to keep the cell phones on. Make sure everybody got a signal. As if. Those towers are also to help to, again, the prince of the power of the air, to help to promote the energies that the prince of the power of the air wants everywhere. Now, the person inside the casino, okay, they're inside of a structure, a building, but where, you know, I worked in Motor City Casino. When I first walked in, and I mean, at this time, I knew about mind control things. When you first walk into the casino, they hit you with all forms of mind control to attach spirits by way of your senses. But again, see, I'm going to keep putting spirits in it. Why? Because I know that that is the only, for me, that was the only part of the harassment that I felt like, oh, okay, I can do something about that. For me, maybe you got enough guns. Huh? They don't make enough guns and ammo for one. They ain't gonna let one person get it. So if you just believe it's the FBEZ or the CIAZ, that's when they may succeed in driving you crazy. You got to know that it's something that you can have a power over. And again, the power's not yours. Like the battle's not yours, it's the Lord's. And if you fear the Lord alone, and you look to the Father alone as the source of your strength and of your protection and of your provision. Again, see, we have to, some folks is not even aware where they have come into a state of double-mindedness at, or even a strong delusion concerning. They don't even realize that they love the Lord. They speak out prayers for their benefit, but there's somewhere in which they've given more fear or reverence to something more than they've given it to the Father. And the legalist, the adversary, the prosecutor, always trying to make a case against you, sees that, jots it down, and by spiritual law has legal right then. Because if you believe in the back of your mind that an AK-47 is more powerful than the Father in heaven, then in the back of your mind, you've given permission to the adversary to come at you with an AK-47. And I'm, you know, that's analogous, but more based in reality than it may sound initially. And it may sound like it is, but it is. I'm trying to tell you. Because again, somewhere inside of a lot of us, we have given it up. We've said to ourselves, wow, this is insurmountable. I know the feeling. Folks, when I came, let me go to the casino and then I'm going to tell y'all about Colorado. Okay. There's a period of time in which after I came from Colorado, it took me about 2-3 weeks to make a video. Okay, now, let's say you work at a porno store. Yeah, you might work at a, let's say you work at a, okay, I know they're few and far between now, but I, you know, on my journeys around this United States, I've seen a lot of things that I thought was obsolete or no longer. Living in a semi-big city, I've seen a video store. I couldn't believe it. Or perhaps you just happen to work in a party store, quote unquote, or a gas station where they happen to sell videos or booty magazines, something of that nature. Being around that every day, first of all, that's a cursed object. And being around that every day, I mean, unless you come in prayed up on 10 every day, you are subjecting yourself to the possibility of letting the spirits that's on that transfer to you. And they could bother you. They could harass you, deal with you on many different levels, especially nowadays, because again, we've crossed a line. Okay, the spiritual tripwires have been tripped en masse. Okay, whereas it was a few folks here and there, a few folks posting videos here and there, a few folks awake here and there. When I first got on YouTube, and I mean, it's just been about 3 years. In 3 years, going on 4 years' time, so much has changed. So many more people have opened up their mind, and so many more people have accepted the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. All praise is due to the true and living God. More people have accepted that the Messiah is their Lord and Savior, and in the power and authority of his name, they can bind up the unclean thing. They can bind up the creeping thing. They can bind up devils, according to the mission of the Great Commission. Everything else is uncivilized. And don't go to teaching folks about J's and Y's unless you are operating in the works. That's the proof of truth. Everything else comes from the father of lies. Period. Especially academia. Especially what Zionists say. I'm through with that, by the way. Okay, but let's continue. Yeah, because I just feel a strange disturbance in the force. And George Lucas, we know, was dealing with Aleister Crowley, and the force was really talking about the demonic source of their power. So again, I just use that because folks are aware of the concept of the force, more so than they're aware of the concept of the Holy Spirit and the supernatural Father. Oh, come on. So if the Father protects you, if God be for, it's in the book, argue with the book. If God be for you, who can be against you? No weapon formed against you can prosper except for psychotronic weapons, except for a reptilian. I know a lot of things, but I don't know enough. Things I don't know fill a volume of encyclopedia books. Okay. Who am I anyway? I'm nothing and no one. Heavenly Father, God, my tongue, God, my heart, God, my mind to be in alignment with your will. Heavenly Father, please forgive me that I did not do this at the very beginning on the recording. But you know I did it inside of my mind and my heart in Jesus' name. Now, we ask, Father, that you would please just guide this conversation in the way that you want it to go. And at the end of the day, Lord God of glory, let it open up the prison to them that are bound, set the captives free, and bind up the brokenhearted. In Jesus' name, and loose somebody out of their misery. Now, in the casino, you walk in the casino, and just like, you know, you could work at the party store or the liquor store, and just because you're around all of them malt liquor signs and symbols, you know, and you got King magazines in the rack right there by you, okay? Might even, you know, where I live around the way, they usually have some kind of twerking video or something like that also behind the counter there, okay? Right there in full view, okay? To have the same effect on you as the things that they put in the impulse aisles as you're walking through the checkout at the supermarket or Target. It's things placed everywhere to jump on you. But again, so folks, okay, hold on. We're gonna go to the higher levels of it because somebody still think I don't understand how specific they can get with this. I don't know if you do. I'm finna tell you a story. If you can just please, bear with me. So you walk through the casino, you hear the ding 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 ding. I would get off the bus on Grand River, walk about half a block, hearing the sights and sounds of the city, you know, cars honking, people cussing. And the second I walk into the casino, yeah, I'm a man of unclean lips. I come from a people with unclean lips. Lord, forgive me. Sometimes I want to cuss. I ain't did it yet. That's a thing of control. I can control myself. Demons and folks who are so demonically bound by the demon spirit of rage or any profane spirit, the spirit of vulgarity, cursing spirits, spirits that want to curse you, they curse at you. Initially, when we get into a deliverance session, that's one way that you know that something has manifest. The person is usually going to cuss for real at us, for real. But Brother Charles, tell you I ain't lying. Anyway, you know, soon as I walked through the door, and I worked in the kitchen, you know, that wasn't no big wig, okay. Small time. I caught the Grand River bus down there, by the way. But soon as I walked through the door, it would hit me, everything. First of all, it's cool in there. So let's say I was coming to work on a summer night. First thing I felt was the cool air. Then there's a smell, there's an aroma. Yes, it is. I was watching on the Learning Channel some time back when they actually used to show documentaries and things, but they've changed, okay? Even if it's still a Learning Channel, I don't even know. But I used to watch on the Learning Channel all these different shows, kind of like How Things Are Made type of shows. And one of them, they talked about the casino. And I watched that with such interest and amazement. And this was way before I had a job at the casino, but they said they had guys on there who were the specialists who come up with the ideas for how can you trigger people to want to spend more money? How can you trigger people to want to play with their money? And I remember too, by the way, I was smoking and drinking a pack of cigarettes. I never bought one in there. Pack of cigarettes at the gas station would cost me $5 and some change. But in the casino, they wanted $8. So everything was high, okay? Sky high as a giraffe's eye. And I'm telling you, soon as you go in there, they hit you with all these things for your senses. Well, yeah, they had dudes on the Learning Channel that even admitted, well, yeah, you know, there's an aroma that we pump through the vents. Yes, I'm not lying to you. I saw this with my own eyes. Now, again, this is lightweight jamming mind control tactics and techniques that harass your mind and soul. There's a group of folks behind this, okay? The casino has investors and whatnot. They are brotherhood members and whatnot. They're not average bear squares. Okay. They papa bear squares. Okay. I remember them telling us that Motor City Casino made something like $70 million a day or $7 million a day, one or the other. I think it was $7 million a day. At that time, this is like 2007. Anyway, so certainly, you know, as soon as you walk in, you hit with all of these sounds. Ding, 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 ding. The sound of somebody winning who ain't even won yet. Okay, I'm sure that's just pumped through the speaker, or they probably have so many machines just on to make that noise, right? Yeah, I'm sure they do. And then, of course, there was the belief by folks in the street. Yeah, girl, go to Motor City Casino. I'm telling you, it's your first time. Girl, you go. You gonna hit. Yeah, I'm trying to tell you. Certainly. And yes, yes, you know, certain spirits was over Detroit, you know, having to do with money and getting money. Okay, women chasing money. Dudes doing anything to get money. It flips the whole dynamic, because then dudes are spending money to get women, and then that puts them in a place of power where a man is supposed to be, if he has God as his head, and the man should be the head. But in a society, or in a microcosm of society, which is what a major city is supposed to be, then you have the man who is under, okay, because he always trying to chase and impress the woman. Spending more money on his vehicle, on his clothes, on his home, on everything, just to try to get her attention or to compete for her attention. Then that puts the women in a psychological or subconscious place of dominance. Some folks here didn't say, well, that ain't just Detroit, bro. Hey, so we on the same page. I said it's a microcosm of what the society as a whole is supposed to be. It's that way in every major city, I'm sure. And that's not, okay, that's not exclusive to race, okay? If you're dark skin or light skin, hello? Either way, 9 times out of 10, that's how it go. Not that you're not supposed to take it. See, folks like to take something and run and flip it and twist it. That's cerebral. I bind in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. See, I almost did it like the movies. Almost got me. In the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and the power of his name, Heavenly Father, I ask you to bind up the demon spirit of cerebro and every demon spirit of intellectualism, Lord God, glory within the sound of my voice and anyone who's listening. Bind it in everlasting and breakable chains and then cast it down into the pit of the abyss and flames, the place of Tartarus, out of darkness, the dungeon of the dragon, wherever the Lord Jesus Christ prefers, according to his words in Matthew 7:7, Matthew 18:18-20, Matthew 21:22, Isaiah 55:11, Numbers 23:19, just to name a few. We ask you to bind those scriptures to this prayer. Heavenly Father, let this prayer reach up to you. Heavenly Father, as a Holy Ghost pillar of fire, let it reach your very ears, Heavenly Father, unhindered in anything unlike you, Lord God of glory, that tries to hinder it, Lord, let it be utterly consumed by Holy Ghost fire. And Lord God of glory, send down the answer in Jesus' name, Heavenly Father, as the same pillar of fire in Jesus' name, Lord God of glory, fire and Holy Ghost flame, and let it consume anything that tries to stop the answer from reaching us right here in this physical realm, Lord, which we touch and agree. We ask that it would be continually, perpetually, and permanently in the authority of the name of Lord Jesus Christ, who does it thoroughly. Amen and amen. So, I'm trying to tell you something. Feel me on this. And guess what? I almost forgot what it was. But see, the devil would like for me to cuss or fuss or to deliver it like this. Like I'm just, you know. He want me to turn down. You want me to be fearfully bound? No. Fearfully and wonderfully made. In Jesus' name. And I'm trying to tell you right now, some of the things that, again, some of the things that we've been led to think are weapons that can be formed against us, we need to redefine and really come up with where we stand on that in our mind. Where do you really stand on that? When it says no weapon, is there an accept in your subconscious thought somewhere? I mean, I'm asking you. Somewhere in the back of your mind, is it accept this? I mean, let's go to the top. What about a nuke? See, I think sometimes folks think I'm a slowish. Okay, let me tell you this. Okay, I brought up the casino thing to say this. Sometimes, too, it is simply because where we work or where we play, where we lay our heads, these places are not consecrated in sealed vessels. Just like you're seeing with the human beings who are not consecrated in sealed vessels, these places are already flooded with demonic energy or already pumping out demonic energy. So many of these places are places and spaces that, you know, Charles and I and others now have been sent out to pray about and pray that the principalities and dominions and fallen angels over these places are bound up and that they have no more ability to bind up the children of the true and living God, the Most High. And now since we've been doing this, again, we get a lot of confirmation that it's not just conversation. I told you, after going to Alabama Power, I'm gonna keep saying it, and prayer walking the building, at the top, Electra was standing there. Now, I made a mistake some kind of way and erased the picture of Electra. I did actually get a picture of her, okay? I pointed the laptop up there while I was using a digital camera to actually zoom in and get pictures of her. Don't know what happened to him, okay? But by the time we got home, which was the room, that evening, and that was the major thing that we did, but that wasn't all we did. That's also the same day I went to the Alabama Civil Rights Museum. It was at in Birmingham, I believe. We were still in Birmingham at that time, where the church bombing happened, and where they had the statue of the little girls who was killed, or, you know, who were sacrificed in that ritual that the Boulay had something to do with as well. But by the time we got home, trust me, I don't prefer one devil to the other. They both can get a 13 in their square tails. But by the time we got home, and I mean, I'm gonna stay like this. If you want me to, demons is after me and the government is chasing us down, and you go to another channel and stay there. But by the time we got to the crib, in this case, by the time we got to the motel, and I checked my phone, I looked in the email there, and I got one thing from YouTube. I don't get something from YouTube every day. I mean, you know, comments come through, but I mean from YouTube proper. They send me two things. They say, congrats, your video's up. Or they say, unplug them, your video has been blocked because of a copyright strike. That's all they say. And they only say that after I put up a video. I hadn't put up no video. We came straight from the Birmingham, Alabama Civil Rights Museum thing. And prior to that, we was prayer walking around Alabama Power. And really focusing on that though, I'm gonna tell you. We really put a lot of prayer into that. Took a lot of pictures of old Electra, Jive Self. Got back to the motel, and lo and behold, what is this? Explain this to me. Lo and behold, I mean, don't ignore me. Listen to my story. Okay? Listen to how I was targeted. Lo and behold, on my phone, I look and I see it says, unplug them. Your video has been blocked for copyright. And I thought to myself, I didn't put up no video tonight or last night. What is this? I opened it up and it said, your video, Electra, such and such. I can't even remember the title of it because I'm telling you, I hadn't thought about it or watched it since I did it in what, 2013 or 14? And then 2016, the same day after we prayer walk around Alabama Power, which is guarded by the principality of Electra, because she's standing on top of there. That same evening, I get this copyright notice. I don't know if they took it down or what. I was so flabbergasted. I didn't want to look into it too much. I accept that I have an enemy that can use technology. I accept that my enemy follows me. I accept that my enemy can tap my phone. I accept that my enemy can look through the camera on my laptop even when it's turned off. I accept that my enemy can turn the radio that I use for a speaker into a microphone. I accept that a microphone in general can be turned into a speaker, and a speaker in general, headphones too, can be turned into a microphone. I accept that my cell phone is live all the time. I accept that they've sent demon spirits to jump into all of these things from time to time. One of them used to only shut down my little laptop that I got from my brother Trey from Motown. The first thing I was ever blessed with in this ministry was a little portable laptop. I liked it too. It was like a little, you know, like having a little 32 walking around. It was very good. I could just tuck it in and go. Lo and behold, I got so busy on that little laptop, all the first videos were, you know, I was being seen all the time. I mean, you know, I had to learn about that. Don't you think that the change in that was a result of some TI action? And I ain't talking about TIP. This motivation. Better get on your job ASAP. But, I mean, hey. They tore that little computer up. Every time I was doing deliverance on that computer, I mean, you know, once I crossed a certain line. And you know when you cross this line, because that's after you cross that line, that's when the activity ramps up. So after I crossed that line, well, what was you doing, Brother Theo? Praying for somebody who had a lot of things going on. That huge secret societies, that powerful secret societies and government agencies and intelligence bureaus was all aware of that there. Now, to tell you my story. And they tore up that computer to where every time I would get on there, if I wasn't doing deliverance, it'd stay on. If I start doing deliverance, it'll cut smooth off, and just keep cutting off until I got it out of my mind as if there was something that was reading my mind. Until I really had given up in my mind, oh man, I can't do that no more today. And really, it even pushed me even further. It made me start to feel like, wow, okay, I need to stop doing this. Mm-hmm. Because doing this is keeping me from being able to speak to all the rest of the people. See, the devil is clever, and this stalking and this harassment, this mischief making in your life can be more than annoying. It can be faith destroying, and it can run you ragged. And I told you, I do not like to run, but after experiencing this, okay, what I'm telling you about, okay. Father inspired somebody to help me get another one. Okay. And like, you know, get top flight security on it and everything. Okay, cool. So I was able to use the other one and sometimes to use the little one. So while I was in Colorado, sometimes I would have both of them up depending on what I was doing. Okay, and in one particular time, I had both of them up. On one of them, I was dealing with the deliverance, okay, on the one that was already malfunctioning. So I said, well, if they take it out, they take it out. And on the other computer, I would not do deliverance. On the newer one, on the one that had top flight security on it. Well, some of y'all was there. It's still there, okay? It's up. In the list of videos, it's 400 some videos. Please don't ask me the name of it. I don't know. But it's the only one, you know, where it's the first one where we did a Google chat hangout. I think it's two of them. It's either the first one or the second one. I don't recall which one. But anyway, in that session, Someone who we've been praying for and who has been delivered was still going through some challenges. Okay. And so in praying for them, you know, I would get a response sometimes from the spirits that had them bound, even over the computer. So yes, I know demon spirits can operate through digital means. Spirits can operate through digital means. Can I say that? I think some folks think, well, no, this is digital. Well, no, this is electronic. Well, no, this is a pulse weapon. I don't care. It's still, again, it's all about the prince of the power of the air. What comes down from satellites, it's all about the prince of the power of the air. What happens with your GPS? Maybe it'll mislead you somewhere into a witch's nest. It's all because of the prince of the power of the air. Those frequencies and energies that fuel these machines and that come off of these machines and that carry our communications are in his dominion. It's one reason why it's called Prince of the Power of the Air. It's another reason why, you know, we spend a lot of time talking about Gemini, which is, again, it's the communications or the demon spirit over communications and evil communications at that, but also over demonstrations, meaning the laugh cry, the laugh now, cry later, or the comedy and drama masks symbolizing Gemini, not just the opposite sex, not just male and female, but also symbolizing these two opposing or seemingly opposing moods. So they can shoot moods. I got it. I know these things. It was happening to me. But the favorite mood that they try to shoot is lust and fear. You have to really be girded up against lust and fear, because they love to shoot those energies through these machines. And we open up many gateways to help them. Jesus said that it would be better that you cast out your eye than let your eye offend you, or cast off your hand and let your hand offend you, or any of your members for that matter. Again, I'm not recommending, you know, don't take that and run with it. Okay? Just consult the one concerning it. Talk to the Father concerning these things. Okay? Try to be sure, again, the back of your mind is not like the basement of your house. Okay, you put things down there, you forget about them. Some of those things will corrode and erode. And then if you let cousin so-and-so and them come over there, some of them things will be missing. The things in the back of your mind are not missing, nor are they truly forgotten. The things in the back of your mind are the things that the devil loves to find, because those are the things by which he can write contracts and agreements on you that you're not even conscious of. You're not aware of them. That's why sometimes in deliverance prayer, we have to add this clause, knowingly or unknowingly. Okay? Consciously or subconsciously. Because you can be bound to a lot of things. Most of the things that keep us bound are things that are rooted back there in the subconscious mind. That's the root. And if the devil can get fear lodged into your subconscious mind, I don't care how you proclaim that you don't have it, in his fear of many things, he will take it how he can. He's so cheap with his lawyering. He is the prosecuting attorney that fuels all accusing attorneys. And as the accuser, he will look for any subconscious agreement you have that says, I don't believe no weapon formed against me shall prosper. I don't believe that if God be for me, who can be against me? I don't believe that the victory is not mine, but it's the Lord's. Okay? I don't believe that the battle is already won. Okay? I don't believe that I'm the head and not the tail. Okay? If any of that is back there, the adversary will exploit it and bring you up on charges because of it. And then you'll be in bondage because of it. In Colorado, on that other little computer there, on the one that I did deliverance on, okay, I thought I saw the demonic presence type out something at me. And again, I generally know that it's them because they start off cussing. This individual did not curse. Okay? But of course, it would, you know, the demonic presence would type under their name on Skype. And so, again, sometimes I would have to ask, you know, hey, is it you? Because sometimes they'll play a little game. Okay? Some of the spirits were, and there's a hierarchy even among demonic spirits. The little lowliest ones can barely spell. Now, listen to me. Some of them are, quote unquote, like generals in hell. There was one, P-A-I-M-O-N. Don't say the name. According to the Goetia, has legions up under him. And he spoke very properly the way that he wrote and spelled everything the old English way. Well, he called me an arse, A-R-S-E. Mm-hmm. Indeed. And this was not the way that this individual wrote. So the entire personality and everything would change when these spirits were able to come through them. So now guess what? I saw something pop up on the screen over there. I said, oh, I wonder, is it them? Or I wonder, is this one of the spirits? Because we was actively praying for them on the other computer. And although I was not intending on doing deliverance that day, I was answering questions. They popped up in there. But all of this, again, there's a prince of the power of the air, and then there's a king of everything who's already designed you to win. So although in my mind at this time, I thought, oh, wow, oh, my God, the devil have jumped into this computer now, through this individual now, who I hadn't even called for this Google chat hangout thing here. Okay, they weren't even supposed to know about it. They end up in there, bloop, in full manifestation. So that's on my big computer, on the new one with top flight security installed on it. Yeah, right. I mean, it's no more. But anyway, on the little one, I saw a message pop up on the Skype. So I said, oh, okay, is this them? What's going on? So by the time I checked out that message, I do believe though they had left out the chat. Okay, we was praying for them. It was manifesting, it was putting up dirty pictures as the icon. It was a trip. Okay? Really trying to interfere with our focus and with our attempts to, you know, we were just having a question and answer session. Miss Lady was there, Brother Denzel was there, you know, different folks was there that have still hung around. Okay? But anyway, I look on the little computer and I see that it's them. It doesn't start off cursing, but it starts off putting me down, so I thought it was just a demon. Check me out. I thought, you know, this was a demon, and you know, I go into my mode, binding and loosing, and demons are taken care of. It said something like, you know you can't win, Theodore. And I got ready to come back at it in cap, but I felt the Father tell me, no, play into this. Check it out. So I played into it. I said, oh, you're right. You know, I'm typing. I said something like, oh, you're right. I'm tired of this losing. You know, I'm tired of being on the losing team. The Father was guiding me on how to play into this. So they typed back to me something like, let me see, what did they say after that? They said something like, yes, just give up. You know that you're going to lose. So I said something like, oh, I'm so tired of you demons, you know, I don't know what made me think I could battle y'all. Now, I thought I was just going to glean some information from a above average intelligent, quote unquote, demon. But it came back and said, well, there is a way that you can win, and I can share it with you if you're serious. And I looked at it and I said, now this don't sound like a demon. And then the next line popped up and said, and this is not a demon. So I said, well, now I know. First thing about demons is they lie. So I said, okay. But just the way that it was writing, I've been accustomed to reading how they write. Even the ones like, oh, Master Peter, whose name I spelled, okay, their master in hell, okay, where he's going to dwell for all of eternity. He spoke so proper, old P-Man. But this wasn't P-Man. This sounded like, I mean, this, just the way of the typing and of the writing. And again, you get a sense for that. Just like you get a sense for when somebody's speaking, when it's them or when something has come over them. There is a way, like it's a vibration. I can hear it and feel it. You know, it does not, the note that it plays is not harmonious with mine. Okay? I can just tell. All praise to the true living Father. So I said, okay. Father, what is this? The Lord just like, keep playing into it. So I said, okay, I'm gonna play into it some more. So make a long story short, I got to talking and playing that, playing that Poe victim role to them. See, that's what they want. I got to saying, oh, I don't know what I'm gonna do. You know my situation, you know I'm poor. You know, I need some help. You know, what can I do? I'm tired of this. I'm tired of fighting this battle. You know, I'm not getting no help. You know, what can I do? Said to me, well, first, erase your YouTube channel. Don't, delete your YouTube account and we can help you. I'm trying to tell you what happened. So I wondered, now how come you can't delete it yourself? Because the Father has placed a hedge of protection over this channel. Now I know this. And I mean, I thought about that then. But we spent about 2 hours. You know, it took me maybe about... I mean, the wishful thinking, it seemed to me, was that I would give in anyway. And so I had that on my side, if you will. They almost felt like they was getting some kind of victory. And they worked somewhere... You're not listening to me. They worked somewhere where there was a crew of them there and everybody had kind of stopped doing what they was doing. I'm sure, you know, on their different computers, messing with different people and different prayer warriors and people in God's army all around the world, I'm sure. Okay, because the person, let it be known in our conversation, you know, I really got their guard down. I'm sure they got fired. But, you know, the person let it be known that, you know, they wasn't in the States, or excuse me, they wasn't where I was, and they wasn't where the person was whom they could remote tap into. They could remote tap into her. And again, you know, there's no condemnation in Christ. Again, that's a done deal. I'm telling the story and... Again, what's overstood should not have to be explained. So don't turn it to no goofy goober because, again, you won't be answered. You may be censored. Why? Out of the respect for other folks and what they've gone through and now claim victory in and conquered in Jesus' name. Okay? So if you think you know, just think you know. Email me, unplugthem@gmail.com. If it's that serious. But the bottom line is this, and it's not that serious if you're just curious. You're missing the bottom line. The bottom line is this. How come they couldn't cut it off themselves? They needed my agreement. I mean, we spent 2 hours time. This dude kept coming back to, I mean, you know, he'd jive with me some, I jive with him some too. Oh yeah, you know, I like this, I like that. Oh, you know, I need this in my life, I need that in my life. You know, can y'all provide it? Oh yeah, sure. And then also this, oh yeah, what do you think about this viewer? What do you think about such and such? Can you tell what spirit that they have on them? So I also discerned through this experiment here, through acting like I was going to perhaps bite the bait, I also was shown that there's some sort of thing like a cabin in the woods that really goes on. Okay, if you don't know what I'm talking about, read the IMDb, but ask somebody about the movie, and if possible, check it out. Okay, there's some sort of command center where they're able to send out these spirits in mass, and they'll find their hosts, and they can remote control the individual by the spirits. Now hear me. And so they told me, first of all, they pointed out a person as an infiltrator, okay, which I thought that was a couple people. I thought that was interesting. But they were trying to see what my discernment was. They were just about giving me a test. You know, I'm going to let up the video where I talked about this, if I can find it, okay? It may be on here, it may not be. But I actually had recorded a video after I left Colorado. Now, I did everything so stealth from that point forward. Can you imagine? I was just about paranoid, okay? Okay, I had to get out of Colorado. I was like, man, I got to get out of here. I got to leave here. You know, it's possible I could have extended my stay or, you know, I wanted to leave after that and come on back. And I came back to Detroit, went and holed up in a motel room, and I was really trying to decide, okay, how long can I hide? Where can I hide? Until, you know, the father sent a friend of mine, you know, I reached out and I talked to a friend of mine, old brother Gino Exo. And, he's the brother that introduced me to Wacko from the NO. And he listened to my story. Like I know some of y'all didn't do just now. But you want somebody to listen to your story and then commiserate with you and, oh, woe is you. And, oh, my goodness, what are you going to do? Oh, you know, but not give you no solution. Some folks don't want the solution for some reason. Or perhaps the solution puts them in a position where they feel like, well, you know, I'm not ready to give up a lifestyle that perhaps would keep the Father from looking favorably upon me and protecting me. Let's deal. Well, to you, let me say this. I've never been perfect. And the Father has been protecting me the whole time. From the first experience that I've ever had with demons, he wanted to show me that you don't protect yourself by your own merits or works, by your strength, by your intellect, by your righteousness, which is as filthy rags. But I choose to protect you if you choose to bow down and fear me only. And even when you're feeling a little shaky about fear me only, if that's the stance that you will to stay upon, I'll honor that. So yeah, you know, I had this long conversation with a handler, and they let it be known that the highest levels of individuals was after this person, whom the Father allowed to come to something lowly and unclean and imperfect as me and my little channel, which don't even have 50,000 subscribers. We don't have 20,000. It's folks that have 1 million. But it's something about this little channel. Like it was something about that little group of people that he so-called the chosen. Now the Father's ready to operate with a little group of people right now, if they're willing to bow down and fear him only. And then to open up their mouths and ask in the authority of the name that is above all names, no matter what you've heard or learned in academia. You're not dealing on this level. So you've not had this level of attack from the devil. He's thrown everything at us. Charles is a witness now. He is a witness. He has thrown everything at us. And it's not by strength or might, because my voice can go deep. Ain't got nothing to do with it, but I'm turned up right now. Because I'm trying to get you to feel me if you won't listen to me. He don't love me more than he love you. The same thing he did for me, he'll do for you too. You have not because you ask not. And when you ask amiss. You asking him for something all the time. Asking his thing. Asking for this. Ask him for the power and authority in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ to bind up devils and cast them down in the pit of the abyss, the place of Tartarus, wherever Jesus prefers to send them, to lay hands on the sick and cause them to recover, and to speak in new tongues, the evidence of the Holy Spirit. Which one are you operating in? You're supposed to be operating in all three. Because sometimes casting out devils is what brings the healing to a person. I can trace everything back that's evil to the devil. You can't do that. The devil made me do it. You've been caught up in this lie that the devil wants to perpetuate through his media and through academia as well, that says, I'm just a myth. I'm not here. You don't see me. I'm not here. Go about your business. I'm not here. That black guy did it. I'm not here. That white guy did it. I'm not here. The president did it. I'm not here. I am clear on my adversary, who is my enemy. It's the only enemy I choose to wage war against. Because in waging that war, seek ye first the kingdom of God, all other things shall be added unto you. In waging that war, everything else that could come my way gets handled. Everything starts in the spirit. Look around your room and name me something that did not first begin as an idea. Come on. Somebody was inspired to make that telephone, to make that clock, to make that coffee cup, to make that lamp, to make that pillow, to make that curtain, to make the carpet on the floor, to make the air conditioner, to make the covers on the bed. Hello. Somebody was inspired to make that Aveeno baby lotion. Somebody was inspired to make that duffel bag. Somebody was inspired to make that fresh pair of top 10 Adidas shoes. And in this land, Babylon, that which has inspired all of these things that we love and that we turn into kings that we love, we bow down and worship these things that we have. Subconsciously or consciously. Damn that Adidas shoe. Literally. I'm not cursing. It ain't nothing to me. I live in the world and not of the world. Unfortunately, I know the way you look is nothing to me. It's something to most folks. So sometimes folks won't receive you unless you come in a disguise. You got to creep up on them sometime. Absolutely. If I had my choice, I'll tell you, I look like a Raggedy Andy and a Booger Bear too. If I had my choice, I'd be clean. I'd put some soap on it. Some respect on it. As far as, you know, trying to look presentable, it's part of the uniform. But my point is, we have taken all of these things that were ideas at one time. And even before that, they were inspired by spirits that jumped into made men's minds. And then made men made them. The made men themselves are nothing but host bodies. I told you what it says on the website. Excuse me, for the greatest Masonic temple. Excuse me, the largest Masonic temple in the world. It's not great. The largest Masonic temple in the world on the website. It uses a peculiar term for members or brothers. It says bodies. It did. We looked it up. My Detroit family. Peace to Sister Sam. Yeah, that's right. Sister Creek. Yep. We was both there that day. I think Brother Rich, I think he was there. But yeah, we was looking up some things. Found it on the website. What does it got to do with anything? Because that is what the Black Awakening is in essence. It is the devil's sloppy copy or answer to the time of the greater works, which is now at hand. I'm declaring it. Because the Father declared it to me, so I declare it to thee. He does not love me more than he loves you. And it was by his design that there be a greater works crew to demonstrate. Not just conversate. Don't talk me to death. I've heard it all before. Heard it all before. And I'm ready to cut that radio off. Them lies ain't working now. Hello? Is this on? Somebody hear me? You're too near me not to hear me clearly. Clearly. This is for you. You and especially you. It's time right now. Because the Father has drawn a line right now. Okay? Incorrect. A great example. Okay? And what a coincidence. Because last night, okay, before that even came up. Now, this just goes to show you. The Father has been showing us signs and symbols that the Black Awakening is going down. Okay? Brother Charles received a sign. Sister Kathy received a sign. They both had to do with this. The sleeping giant that's in people, or really, really, you know, to be more direct, the sleeping chihuahua, okay, a hot dog dog, something you ain't gonna be scared of. You shouldn't be scared of anyway. It'd make a lot of noise. It'd run up on you, just about up on you. A big dog is gonna run up on you, leap on you, jump on your chest. When them little ones, because of having a complex, a little one's complex. Demons have a complex. It can run up on you just so far. And all you gotta do is stomp your foot. Hey, stomp your foot. Boom. And they stop. Startle them. And run back. That's how you should look at a demonic attack. I'm sorry. You prefer to look at it like somebody's blue nose just got loose. That's on you. And you know, if I can help you with that more, I would like to. Email me, unplugthem@gmail.com. I'm not making light. I told you, I was terrified. Hiding on the bus, on the Greyhound bus coming back from Colorado. How you hide on the bus, Brother Theo? Not very well. When you 200 plus pounds and 6 plus feet. Okay, and I mean, I was scared because I was not prepared. As many demon fights as I've been through and whatnot, now, how do I deal with the people? Now I know the people is on me. That's why when the FBI van was behind me and my man, 50 grand again, Brother Mr. Charles, you know, hey, I know Goofy Goobers can name their Wi-Fi signal that, and okay, they can. But what a coincidence, it's an FBI surveillance van, and we was doing what we was doing and saying what we've been saying. Okay? It ain't like we just, you know, lightweight jamming around here all day. I overstand. Okay? And it's interesting because, you know, the same, you know, it's like, what do folks want when you deal with this subject, okay? I'm giving it all to you, the way that I've seen it, okay? I'm giving you my honest feelings on it, by the way. Everything. And yes, it happens, but yes, we can conquer it. And yes, it's also a sign that whatever the adversary is doing, our Father has already come up with a much greater design. And his way is the way. It will prevail. So the very fact that we can see this awakening going on all around us, that's what it is. So many people getting harassed now. Why? I mean, on some real stuff. Are you putting out this level of... So why is it happening now? Because there's... Again, something has been broadcast. Again, God is no respecter of persons. Okay, I'm just a man. But I mean, you know, I've been doing and saying things now for some time. Going against Boule people. Putting y'all up on Dick Gregory, how he running a true comedy game. How all of a sudden he's got this new type of respect on his name. He wasn't like that before. Where was he at when Steve Coakley and Khalid Muhammad was kicking down the door? Not talking too much. You ever heard of Dick Gregory diet mix? You can go back and listen to Robin Harris. Let me just get this real fast. I'm through with this. You can go back and listen to Robin Harris stand up. I think it was on HBO. Robin Harris set the blueprint for the modern stage and age of comedy, and he's never given that credit. As a person who notices biters and whatnot, okay, you know, because I notice the creative folks always have. But as a person that notices who be biting, I noticed that after Robin Harris died, quote unquote, I believe he was sacrificed. And because of the end result, once he was gone, everybody and their mama just kind of slid in his slot. Folks took his delivery, folks took his presentation, they took some of his material, flat out. But Robin Harris said, you know, he was talking about Dick Gregory. He didn't mention, I mean, you know, he did not diss Dick Gregory, but the mention that he made of him was as a dude who makes a diet drink. Yeah, well, he marched beside Dr. King, so did Messy Jesse. Hello? Where was Dick Gregory before? Okay, when certain folks needed to be seen as more credible, they went and got somebody who has been put in movies like Panther. Oh, come on now. Y'all got some game about yourself. Just because a dude grow a old long orangutan beard and look at you wide-eyed in the camera and shake his finger and fake his anger, don't mean he's nothing for you at all. I mean, we can trace him back to the Boule from the very beginning, and from we can trace him back to his dealings with Hugh Hefner, who was a mind controller. Hugh Hefner put him on mind control from the beginning. You can look at his history. You can see how he was always involved in something to put black folks in mind control. Oh, you're not ready. And then let's deal with Steve Coakley, who is gone. I ain't never said Steve Coakley was a saint. I know a lot of things I could say, but one thing I can't is that Steve Coakley hid the Boule thing from us. He revealed it. When a whole lot of black folks was just, oh, the white man in the Illuminati, white man in the Illuminati. Steve Coakley's like, hold on, wait a minute. Certain things couldn't even get accomplished without having boots on the ground in the black part of town, on the other side of town. Curtis Mayfield. So who are those people? He pointed them out. He said Dick Gregory was the first one that he discovered. And say, upon pressing Dick Gregory about it, in Dick Gregory's classic fashion of talking too much, he told on this, he dry snitched on himself. And then when he picked up on the fact, well, wait a minute, I shouldn't have told this dude, Steve, about this. Then he went to try to backpedal. And Steve was like, hey, you know, can I put you on a video talking about this? Can I interview you about this? Then Gregory basically paraphrased and said, no, Lord, not me. Master ain't gonna come get me. And Dick Gregory and them other folks is mad because of a little channel like this having the effect that it has had. Because of the true and living God. This is a little channel. So I laugh at folks and say, oh, you've been exposed. No, you've been exposed. I don't get nothing out of this from them. Everything I get out of this come from him. And I'm pointing up to the true and living father of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Get it right. Quote me, but don't misquote me. And if I got it wrong, I'll tell you. What you gonna do, beat me up? I'm through with you. My father ain't gonna allow it to happen. How about that? Touch not my anointed, do my prophets no harm. I believe what he's saying. I'm an imperfect man. I belong in hell. Okay? He could have cast me down. He could have canceled my check a long time ago. Stopped my heart for all the wickedness that I've done. But it was out of his good pleasure and his grace and mercy that he placed a hedge of protection around me. And I'm here to tell you, he don't love me more than he love you. How come them folks, when was I in Colorado, y'all? How come them folks ain't came and got me? They know where we at. I signed my name on the motel receipts. They was following us. Yes, that was them. That wasn't just some goofy goober in, where was we at? Newport, no, not Newport, Texas. What was it called? Some Tennessee. Newport, Tennessee, I think it was. Nah, we done been so many places now, I'm starting to forget. That means we've been traveling like Willie Nelson on the road again. And we finna do a little more. Then we ain't gonna do no more. A little more. We got two more stops before I stop. But anyway, so I said all of that to say that it's time for you to be awakened. Time for us to be awakened. You can see things on TV now. They're flashing the lights in such patterns as to activate the empty heads. The analogy of Agent Smith when he pops into the helicopter pilot, or when he pops into people driving on the street, or even when he uses the Scarlet Lady, the Lady in Red, in the training exercise, when Morpheus is showing Neo about how he need to pay attention. Okay. Keep his attention bill current. Keep it paid up. And he didn't. In the training exercise, in the training simulation that Morpheus took old Neo through, Keanu Reeves looked at the Lady in Red as she walked by slow motion, and he's looking at her, focusing on her, and as soon as he turned back, bam, Agent Smith was right there. That's the Black Awakening personified, okay? I even like it better when old Agent Smith jumps into the dude that's the helicopter pilot, and he just, you know, dude head shake real fast. Brother Charles went and got coffee last night and experienced that from the young man working at the Wawa. Wawa, va-va, ya is positive and va is negative, if that is what folks want to deal with. Again, if you're dealing with academia, you go all the way back to the Babylonian and Sumerian, because you have to remember, Israelites spent a lot of time in Babylon, and so a lot of what the Babylonians had learned became ingrained in what we now know as Hebrew. If you look at both, you'll see it. But see, some folks get so enthralled into, and again, that's why his yoke is easy, his burden is light. Who's right? Who's right? Every few days, I get somebody telling me, no, the name is this. Ain't none of y'all in agreement, and ain't none of y'all operating out of the works. That's going to change, though. We're about to see the adversary show up and show out with his magic and wizardry on a whole nother level. Let me say that, okay? No, it will never change, because again, they're unable to heal or to bind up and cast something down, for real. They can move some things around, okay? Spirit's playing a game. And folks who do anything in any other name are falling victim to that game, or they're receiving the grace and mercy of the Father, because we did recognize that as well. The Father sent us a young man of God who was, and I mean, not, again, it wasn't consistently, but he had the word in him so tough that that's all he needed to add to his game, to jump out of what the folks that run society want you to believe is the name. It's no longer a secret thing. When we was first learning these things, you know, in black consciousness groups and black awareness groups and black nationalism, all that type of stuff, you know, it was kind of a a little group of folks saying, oh, well, no, the name is not Jesus. You know, a little group of us. Now that's the mainstream. Things have changed. Times have changed. And now the majority of folks are saying, well, no, maybe I shouldn't say the name Jesus. And as society gets more and more devilish. Again, he knows his sheep voice and his sheep know his voice. But what I've seen and what I'm continually seeing is that it has been his choice and good pleasure to bring everybody out of that bondage of intellectualism and of believing that for some reason, okay, academics would not want to hide the real name. Going to such great lengths as to mess with etymology, as to mess with history, going to great lengths to lie to you about the origin of the J and the Y. They wouldn't go that far, but you believe in the Mandela effect. I'm through with you. I'm through with you. So Brother Theo, are you saying that it's not happening? Yeah, the Mandela effect is happening, but I'm saying it's not happening for the reason that you think is happening. Now they're playing with your memory and with your ability to know what you know and that it works for you. Because if you keep going to the facts as the proof of truth and they keep changing the facts, you will constantly be in a state of confusion and doubt, in fear. You're not overstanding. So what should be the proof of truth? You stand on the word of the true and living God until the very end, although it might look odd. That's what you got to do. And begin to ask for the greater works to manifest in you. Revel in the fact that your Father is the true and living and the true and loving, the King of everything. And fearsome, the only thing to fear. And does arise for the poor and for the needy when you cry out. James 5 and 16 is a reality. So is Hebrews 11 and 1. You have to have faith in things unseen. You got to read it in a book. It's the fervent and effectual prayer. Not having the right word or the wrong word or this concordance or that concordance. It's why he listens to the poor and the needy and the grandma. They can cry out from their heart. He wants it from your heart, not because you think you're smart. Cerebro, just jump back in somebody. They just called him back. Bind up any and every demonic attack, especially attacks on your ability to feel by the Holy Spirit. You're going to need the Holy Spirit to lead you for real and not have faith in your brain, your intellect, or none of these technological devices. Devices. The things that he devises. These devices. Electra, Isis, that electric energy, that false energy from that false entity. So now let's get down to the brass tacks. Okay, so to call for the greater works. We have not because we ask not. Now let's look at Hebrews 11 and 1. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. For by it the elders obtained a good report. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. So again, this is showing you that everything begins in spirit, and we want to begin in the Holy Spirit, not the phony spirit. So you want to get into a place of comfort. Call forth the Comforter, and you ask. We have not because we ask not, so let us ask. And we're not asking amiss. We're asking in line with this and in line also with what Messiah said concerning the greater works. Perhaps we need to look at that real fast. Let's look at that in Jesus' name. And again, anything that you see the adversary doing, you have to know that your Father has already prepared you for it and has already gone above and beyond the adversary's abilities. And not just matched, but surpassed any and everything that you look at as a great work or a great sign and wonder done by the adversary. So let's look. let's see what the Lord says concerning it. In John 14 and 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. So that's the first step, doing the works of the Lord Jesus Christ. How do you know what these works are? Look at Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. Model yourself after the Savior. He is the model for model behavior. Then, of course, you begin not just to operate in faith, but in works. Faith without works is dead. So that means that you need to not only believe that you can do the things of the Lord Jesus Christ, but you need to begin to do them. And he said, these signs shall follow them that believe. And the signs are simple. We quote them oftentimes. The signs are, you shall cast out devils in the name of Jesus. You shall lay hands on the sick and they will recover. And you shall speak in new tongues. Now those, again, those are the words of the Messiah. Okay? So that's what he says defines a believer. The foundation of if you are a believer or not. And perhaps, you know, we can say, well, all three of those things are equal because, you know, the Messiah said all three. This may be. But you can also make an argument that perhaps if any of those works appears, at least, and again, you know, we walk by faith, not by sight, but at least from what spiritual intelligence or discernment tells some of us, and then if fear tells others, okay, is that the hardest of those would be to cast out devils, because it's the thing that's least taught in churches. You'll find more churches believing that, hey, if we pray for Elder Mother Catherine, that, hey, she will recover. And then you have many more churches that will, you know, get strong into the spirit. They'll have praise and worship sessions, and then folks will begin to speak in other tongues. But not as many churches are operating in perhaps the most dramatic, maybe we can say that, of the three. And that is to cast out devils in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, 14 and 12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, the works that I do, shall he do also. And greater works than these shall he do. Semicolon. Because I go unto my Father. Now. And out of the mouths of babes and sucklings comes perfected praise. So we want to get into a place like a child and receive what the Father has to give us. First of all, not through intellect. You can't wrap your mind around doing the works of the Lord Jesus Christ. It has to be by spirit, not by might, not by strength. It does not matter how much you bench. You don't obtain these things through anything of the flesh. It does not matter how much you read. It does not matter how many ancient languages that you learn and study. You obtain these things through asking. As Jesus said, some of us have a hard enough time believing, but unfortunately, a problem asking the Father. Perhaps there's some underlying doubt or subconscious doubt that your Father is faithful and true, and that he will do exactly what he sends his word out to do, according to Isaiah 55 and 11. So again, so we open up our mouths and we ask. Now, perhaps there are some things that need to be lifted off of us. Okay, perhaps we need to clean the slate somewhat before we place anything new upon it. So, if you will just touch and agree with me, we're going to go through a little list of things. And like Winworldly says, don't cafeteria on me. You know, he is a great and mighty elder in general. Not a perfect man, but you know, God rest his soul, he's going on. But, he definitely taught us a lot of things that we need to understand, overstand, and understand as a body, trying to operate as believers. And Jesus said, these three signs shall follow them that believe. Winworldly said, you know, when doing a mass deliverance, don't cafeteria on me now. Don't say, oh yeah, I have some of this. Oh no, no, I don't have any of that. Well, yeah, yeah, I might have a little of this. Don't go through that in your mind. Just let all of the list be read. Okay, and it's better to have it and not need it than to need it and not have it. Okay, like I once heard it said. So, again, we're just going to go through the list. And if it's there, just be in agreement that the Father will reach down with his right hand of righteousness, extended off his mighty saving arm, and with his mighty sword of Isaiah 34:6, he'll cut it. Okay? He'll cut it loose from you. He will loose you from it. And then we will have it bound up and cast down. Okay? Again, by asking. So let's do it now. All right? And then a very small prayer for anointing. So let's do it. All right. We touch and agree in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and the power of his name. Father, we ask that you would please, Lord, loose us from any and every spirit that we name. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you would then bind it up in everlasting unbreakable chains and then cast it down into the pit of the abyss in flames, the place of Tartarus, outer darkness, the dungeon of the dragon, wherever Lord Jesus Christ prefers, because it's all done according to his words. We are nothing and no one. Nothing that we're asking you to do can be done except we do it by asking you in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would loose us right now from any and every spirit of heaviness, Lord God of glory. Loose us from every spirit of brokenheartedness, in Jesus' name. Loose us from every spirit of continual sadness, in Jesus' name. Loose us from every spirit of unworthiness, the sons of Belial, in Jesus' name. Loose us from every ancestral and familial spirit, Heavenly Father, associated with any of these things, going back to the fourth, fifth, and sixth generation. Loose us from any and every demon spirit associated with masonry or being a mason, in Jesus' name. Loose us from any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of Freemasonry or Rosicrucianism, in Jesus' name, or belonging to the Eastern Star or the Fraternal Order of Police, in Jesus' name. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit of Semiramis or Nimrod, upon which masonry is based, in Jesus' name. Loose us from any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of Isis, Horus, or Set, or Osiris, or Ra, in Jesus' name. Loose us, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, from any and every demon spirit of isolation or depression, fear, terror, trauma, betrayal, abandonment, condemnation, suppression, accusation, embarrassment, judgment, bitterness, bitter root judgment, resentment, brokenheartedness, low self-esteem. Loose us from any spirit, Heavenly Father, of being violated or violating others. Any demon spirit of self-abuse, low self-worth, in Jesus' name. Worthlessness, in Jesus' name. Unloved spirit, in Jesus' name. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of embarrassment, in Jesus' name, Heavenly Father, or disappointment, in Jesus' name. Resignation, suicide, abuse, sexual abuse, mental abuse, physical abuse, in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, going back to the fourth, fifth, and sixth generations. Loose us from any and every demon spirit of sadomasochism, in Jesus' name. Sadism, in Jesus' name. Every spirit that's sadistic, every masochistic spirit, in Jesus' name. Every cutting spirit, in Jesus' name. Spirits of tattoos, in Jesus' name. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit of anger or rage, in Jesus' name. Arakan, in Jesus' name. Deception, in Jesus' name. Tiamaticus, in Jesus' name. Loose us from any and every unteachable spirit, in Jesus' name. Unleadable spirit, in Jesus' name. Any spirit of intellectualism, in Jesus' name. Any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, Lord God, of cerebro, in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from any spirit of rationalizing, in Jesus' name. Loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit of false identity, in Jesus' name. Confusion, double-mindedness, victimization, disassociation. Loose us from any and every bruised spirit, battered spirit, or broken spirit, in Jesus' name. Loose us from any and every spirit of unforgiveness, in Jesus' name. Any and every spirit of the recluse or reclusiveness, withdrawal, disassociation, denial, pride, delusion, racism, prejudice, any demon spirit of a false sense of self, any demon spirit of a lost sense of self, any demon spirit of obscenities, vulgarity, profanity, negativity, disgust, drivenness, discouragement, despondency, despair, dejection, defeatism, death, yes, Lord, crying, in Jesus' name, hyperactivity, in Jesus' name, indifference, inactivity, inner hurts, deep hurt, insomnia, laziness, lethargy, listlessness, loneliness, morbidity, mourning, negativity of any kind, tiredness, torment, a troubled spirit or troubled mind, every spirit of weariness and well-doing, every wounded spirit, any spirit of sleepiness, sorrow, or self-pity, in Jesus' name. Bind up any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, Lord God, away of accusation or anger from accusation. any argumentative spirit, backbiting, belittling, bickering, or bitterness spirit, or any spirit of blasphemy, any spirit that causes division, disunity, coarse jesting, competition, or contention, covetousness, war spirits, in Jesus' name, Aries and Taurus, in Jesus' name, loose from every spirit of Gemini, in Jesus' name, or Cancer, or Leo, in Jesus' name, or Virgo, or Libra, or Scorpio, in Jesus' name, or Sagittarius, in Jesus' name, or Capricorn, in Jesus' name, any Aquarian spirit, in Jesus' name, and any and every spirit of Pisces, in Jesus' name, loose from all spirits, Heavenly Father, Lord God, of glory, fantasy, and dreaming, in Jesus' name, any and every demon spirit of New Age, and witchcraft, and rebellion, in Jesus' name, every perverse spirit, in Jesus' name, every spirit of lust, in Jesus' name, pornography, porne, sexual deviation, sexual perversion, in Jesus' name, incest, harlotry, in Jesus' name, whoremongering, in Jesus' name, any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of chronic worrying, in Jesus' name, crankiness, in Jesus' name, doctrinal error, affectation, agitation, in Jesus' name, arrogant spirits, boastful spirits, egotism, frustration, in Jesus' name, flustered spirits, hallucination, in Jesus' name, irritability, lofty looks, high-mindedness, in Jesus' name, infirmity of any and every kind, every sickness of the body, spirit, soul, or mind, in Jesus' name, all spirits of mental illness or madness, in Jesus' name, mania or panic, in Jesus' name, loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, that's deaf or dumb, and every spirit of fear, in Jesus' name, loose us, Heavenly Father, from any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of fear of authority, in Jesus' name, or fear of compromise, in Jesus' name, or hypochondria, in Jesus' name, inadequacy, in Jesus' name, insanity, ineptness, indecision, in Jesus' name, loose us from every spirit of nightmare or mare, in Jesus' name, loose us from every night demon, Lilith spirits, succubus or incubus spirits, in Jesus' name, in any and every spirit of timidity, in Jesus' name, in any and every spirit of manipulation or being manipulated, in Jesus' name, in every demon spirit of unbelief, in Jesus' name, unreality, in Jesus' name, in every demon spirit of suspicion or paranoia or schizophrenia or disassociative identity disorder, mind control, MK Ultra, Project Monarch, in every demon spirit of monarch or sex kitten programming or alpha beta programming or any and every demon spirit of violence or murder, in every spirit of murder programming, in Jesus' name, every spirit of criticism or dominance, in Jesus' name, and slavery, every robot spirit, in Jesus' name, every spirit of the drone or high-mindedness, mind control of any kind, in Jesus' name, and in every demon spirit of mesmerism or hypnotism, in Jesus' name, and Lord God of glory, we ask that you would bind up any and every demon spirit of addiction, addictions to alcohol, caffeine, in Jesus' name, cigarettes, in Jesus' name, drugs of any kind, pharmakia, pharmacon, Hermes, Harmon, in Jesus' name, Gemini, in Jesus' name, the Jinn, any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, of addiction to food, in Jesus' name, anorexia, bulimia, gluttony, in Jesus' name, overeating, in Jesus' name, not feeling full or satisfied, any and every demon spirit of dissatisfaction, in Jesus' name, any and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, of food as idolatry, in Jesus' name, or idolatry of any kind, Lord God of glory, in Jesus' name. And Father, we ask that you would bind up all of the demon spirits that we just named and every spirit, Heavenly Father, associated with them in Jesus' mighty, matchless, holy name. Every spirit that let them in, every spirit that they let in, every jinn, every fallen angel, every power, might, principality, dominion, spirit of wickedness in a high place or a low place, entity, energy, or force of any kind, Heavenly Father, and bind them all up right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and keep them bound in everlasting, unbreakable chains, and then cast them down into the pit of the abyss and flames, the place of Tartarus, outer darkness, the dungeon of the dragon, wherever Lord Jesus Christ prefers, because it's all done according to his words, in Jesus' name. In Matthew 7 and 7, Matthew 18 and 18 through 18 and 20, Matthew 21 and 22, Isaiah 55 and 11, and Numbers 23 and 19, just to name a few. And we ask that you would bind those scriptures, Heavenly Father, to this prayer, in Jesus' name, and bind those scriptures to everyone who's listening out there, in Jesus' name. And let this prayer in its entirety be bound with those scriptures, and let it reach your very ears, let it rise up, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, and turn from smoke into a pillar of Holy Ghost fire, in Jesus' name, and let it rise up to your very ears, in Jesus' name. unhindered. Let it burn up, consume anything unlike you, Lord God, of glory, that would try to stop it. And let it reach your very ears and then show us the manifestation of it being answered unhindered the same way right here in this physical realm. So, Lord God of glory, we ask that you bind right now in Jesus' name a billionfold portion of power, love, and a sound mind, oneness with the mind of the Lord Jesus Christ, the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, Heavenly Father, Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, to comfort all who listen, and let them be a source of comfort unto others. Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, a billionfold portion of the garment of praise to lift off every spirit of heaviness, Lord, that we just named. And Heavenly Father, any other spirit of heaviness that needs to be lifted off, we ask that you would bind it up right now in Jesus' name and cast it down into the pit of the abyss, the place of Tartarus, utter darkness, wherever Lord Jesus Christ prefers to send it, and let it be manifest right now. Bind it up in everlasting unbreakable chains. Let it come out, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, even through a cough. And bind it up and cast it down out of the listener, utterly and thoroughly, completely, continually, we touch and agree, and know that it would be. Heavenly Father, we ask that you would also bind to all of us a billionfold portion, Heavenly Father, right now, of the seven spirits as told by the prophet Isaiah and the Ancient of Days in the book of Revelation, the spirit of knowledge, wisdom, understanding, counsel, God's might, the spirit of the Lord, and the spirit of the fear of the Lord. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you would also bind to all of us, Heavenly Father, the courage and strength and strategy in battle of the Lion of the tribe of Judah, of Joshua and of his armies, of David the king, of all the mighty men of valor who you sent into battle to claim victory in the power and authority of your name, and even of Samson, in Jesus' name, Lord God of glory. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you would also bind to all of us, Heavenly Father, more wisdom than King Solomon, in Jesus' name, and all the provision necessary for the mission of the Great Commission, and give us more overstanding, understanding, and understanding and wisdom than King Solomon and how to use it, in Jesus' name, and not let it be depleted, in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, bind up everything, Heavenly Father, associated with the spirit of lack. Bind up the cankerworm, and the palmer worm, and every demon spirit, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, of the destroyer and the waster, in Jesus' name. Bind it up in everlasting unbreakable chains and cast it out of us, down into the pit of the abyss and flames, or wherever Lord Jesus Christ prefers. And Lord, we ask that you would also bind to us a billionfold portion of Ephesians 6 whole armor of God, in Jesus' name, that will be ever renewing like you renew the eagle's wings every second, in Jesus' name. Let it renew, Lord God of glory, more so than the skin of Wolverine, in Jesus' name. Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord God of glory, that you would also bind Ephesians 6 whole armor of God to the angels that you have assigned to watch over us, according to Psalm 91. And we ask that you would bind to all of us, Psalm 91, in Jesus' name. And we ask that you would let their Ephesians 6 whole armor of God also be ever renewing like the eagle's wings, in Jesus' name. From the crown of our heads to the soles of our feet. And Heavenly Father, we ask that they would also be shod in the same way, from the crown of their heads to the soles of their feet, with ever renewing armor of Ephesians 6 whole armor of God, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you would also bind a billionfold portion, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, of the Holy Spirit, ever renewing also to those angels, in Jesus' name. And bind to us the promise of Psalm 91 and Psalm 91, in Jesus' name. Lord God of glory, Lord God, we ask that you would loose the angels that you have assigned to watch over us in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, lest we dash our foot against a stone, Lord. Let it bear us up and pull us out of the mire and the muck, in Jesus' name. Lord, and let them protect our dwellings made of flesh and bone, as well as our dwellings made of brick and stone, also known as our home, or wherever we may roam. Lord God of glory, let them come like bodyguards and go bodyguard hard in the spirit realm, in Jesus' name, to protect us from all things seen and unseen and anything unclean, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, we ask in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and the power in his name, Lord, that you would bind to all of us the promise of Jeremiah 33 and 3, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, let us all live by Proverbs 3 and 5, in Jesus' name. And bind to us, Heavenly Father, a billionfold portion of ever-increasing Hebrews 11 and 1, now faith, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, we ask that you would also bind to all of us, in Jesus' name, a billionfold portion, Lord God of glory, right now, of peace that surpasseth all understanding, of the oil of joy and gladness to be ever flowing over our lamps, in Jesus' name. Let it be constantly renewing. And bind to all of us a billionfold portion, Heavenly Father, of the of the joy of the Lord, which is our strength, in Jesus' name. And of a merry heart to do our bodies good like a medicine, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, that you would loose a mighty and terrible heavenly host and army of warring angels, Heavenly Father, and that you would bind to them. Ephesians 6, whole armor of God, ever renewing like the eagle's wings, Lord God of glory, and let them protect us, Heavenly Father, continuously, continually, perpetually, and permanently from all unclean things. Let them be dispatched, Heavenly Father, in any sign of trouble, in Jesus' name, on the double, and send them out before us to make our ways straight and our pathways clear, in Jesus' name. And let them bind up any and every demon spirit of the prince of the power of the air, every power, might, principality, dominion, spirit of wickedness in a high place or a low place, fallen angel, entity, or energy, in Jesus' name, that they come into contact with, Lord, let them bind them up in everlasting, unbreakable chains and cords instantly, in Jesus' name, and let them thwart all of those demon spirits and then cast them down into the pit of the abyss, the place of Tartarus, or wherever Lord Jesus Christ wants them bound, in Jesus' name. And Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord, that they would be forever cast down, in Jesus' name, continuously, continually, perpetually, and permanently, in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, because you do it so thoroughly. And Heavenly Father, we ask, Lord God of glory, that you would also bind to all of us a billionfold portion, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory, of the anointing of Ezekiel, Isaiah, Jeremiah, and the Messiah, to lay hands on the sick and cause them to recover, and Elijah, to speak in new tongues and to cast out devils in the name and the authority of the name of the Messiah, Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Lord and Savior, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we ask, Heavenly Father, that you would bind to all of us right now, in Jesus' name, a billionfold portion of ever-renewing gifts of the greater works, in Jesus' name, Heavenly Father. Yes, Lord, bind to all of us the gift of the greater works. Let it be ever-renewing daily, in Jesus' name, and ever-increasing daily, in Jesus' name. And let it be so continually, continuously, perpetually, and permanently, in the authority of the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We touch and agree, and we ask that it would be, and therefore it is. In Jesus' name, we touch and agree, and it is so. Thank you, Father. We love you. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. Amen and amen. No need to say any more. Thank you, Father, because he has done it. So give him some praise. Hallelujah. Glory to the Lamb of God. You alone are worthy to be praised. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord God of glory. I am not worthy. I am nothing and no one, Heavenly Father, Lord God of glory. I thank you so much, Heavenly Father, for the Holy Spirit. I thank you so much, Heavenly Father, for choosing me, Lord God of glory. I thank you so much for guiding me, Lord, in Jesus' name, Lord. Let me continue to seek after you, Father. For you said, seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all other things shall be added unto you. And I believe your word. Every word is faithful and true, and I'm going to stand on it no matter what the devil do. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Shalom.